understand that in the dunya. If you want to go to varsity, to university, you have to have a matric certificate. You have to have set that particular test and exam. Then only will you qualify to get closer, to get higher. Allahu Akbar. Allah says, I will test every one of you. And as I test you, you will then go higher and higher. And He says very clearly, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا ابْتَلَاهُ. It is only when Allah loves you that He will test you with more tests. Subhanallah. Imagine when you want a bigger certificate, you have got 10 degrees, 12 degrees, university degrees. Do you think they will come to you just like that? No, you need to work for them, subhanallah. You need to work very hard, and you need to spend sleepless nights, and you need to endure and persevere. That is when you will have that certificate. The same applies to the certificate of closeness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, I will test you with a small test. Then He tells us, عِظَمُ الْأَجْرِ مَعَ عِظَمِ الْإِبْتِلَى. The bigger the test, the bigger the reward. Allahu Akbar. So when there's a huge test, it is because Allah loves you even more. If you only perceive it that way, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تُتْرَكُوا وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ. Allahu Akbar. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تُتْرَكُوا وَلَمَّا يَعْلَمِ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا مِنْكُمْ وَيَعْلَمَ الصَّابِرِينَ. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ. الله أكبر. So many questions Allah is asking us. Do you think you are going to enter paradise without a test? No, that's impossible. Allah says, do you think you are going to be left? Do you think you are going to be left without us testing you to see who struggles in our way and in our path and who is patient really and who is not? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Do you think you can get into university without a matric certificate? I don't think that's possible. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So do you think you will enter into Jannah without being tested? Only the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do that for you. Allahu Akbar, we ask Allah's mercy. Really, we are weak, we are men. And we want the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ حَتَّى نَعْلَمَ الْمُجَاهِدِينَ مِنْكُمْ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَنَبْلُوَ أَخْبَارَكُمْ. Allah says, we will definitely test every single one of you until we know who struggles, who is patient, and until we test every single department of yours. We will test everything. We will give you money to test you. We will take it away to test you. We will give you children to test you. We will take them away to test you. We will give you happiness to test you. We will give you sadness to test you. We will have your feet amputated to test you. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not test us with tests that we will fail. Tests that are too big for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us ease with these tests. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises He's going to test us. Let's go and look at what is it that He will test us with. He tells us in the Quran. He makes us ready for it. He prepares us for it. Subhanallah. He says here in Surah Al-Baqarah,
وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ.
We will test you. Allah makes mention of five things in Surah Al-Baqarah in this verse. Allah says, we will test you with some fear, firstly. We will test you with fear. You will be scared sometime. You might have an enemy in your direction. You might have some form of fear of becoming sick or ill, some form of fear of a big disease, some form of fear of loss, any form of fear. Allah says, we will test you with it to see if you rely on us or if you rely on everything besides us. And to see whether you are going to complain about us to us or even to others. Because an ignorant person complains about Allah to his creatures. To say, you know what Allah did to me, I don't understand. Allahu Akbar, we don't want to do that. Al-Jahilu. الجاهل يشكو الله إلى الناس. This is the height of ignorance. The ignorant person who complains about Allah to the creation. Allahu Akbar. To say, look what happened to me. Hey, I can't tolerate this. What are you trying to say? You are trying to say that you're not happy with Allah being in command and in control. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never ever make us from amongst those. So Allah of food or through possibly the inability to purchase the food or the inability to eat it because of sickness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So many people cannot eat so many different types of food as a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see, are you going to really understand the plan of Allah? Are you a true mu'min? Allah made it a condition for you to say, I believe and I am happy with the decision of the Creator. If that is the case, why then do we complain? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after that I will test you with your wealth. With lack of wealth, I will decrease that wealth. I will take it away from you. I will cause loss in your life in order to test you, to give you an opportunity to come closer to me, to give you an opportunity to pass an exam. Allah says, He is with those who bear patience. We read that verse moments ago. Which means if Allah did not test you and give you the opportunity to be patient, where were you going to get that level from? Hence, patience is an act of worship which will make you arrive closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Had it not been for calamity in your direction, you would never have been given the opportunity to engage in a huge act of worship known as patience. Hence, patience is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so are at times the tests that Allah puts in our direction. May Allah not test us with tests that are too big for us. We have to repeat that, because tonight we are talking of the tests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of us have been tested and are being tested and is being tested here and now and every single moment of our lives. And a lot of what we say tonight will be relevant to almost all of us, if not every single one of us. And this is why it's important we constantly make a dua for the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah says, I will test you with your wealth. Your factory will burn down just to see what do you do. Do you become depressed or do you thank Allah subhanallah? The friends of Allah, the ones who have a strong iman, the ones who believe firmly in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when their factory burns down, they still say, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. Ala kulli hal, on every condition I thank Allah. He is the one who gave it to me in the first place, I thank Him for it. He decided to take it away, I thank Him for it. I will now get up and start working again instead of becoming depressed. Because depression mostly is a sign of weakness of faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah has decided something and we are upset with it or we cannot digest it, in that particular instance we will probably depress ourselves. If we are to follow the true rules of Islam and the regulations, it will lead us to be happy at all times. عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٌ. Amazing are the affairs of a believer. They are all good for him. إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاهُ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If goodness comes in his direction, he thanks Allah and that is better for him. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاهُ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. And when calamity comes in his direction, he bears patience and sabr, so that was even better for him. Allahu Akbar. That is the affair of a true believer. Let us ask ourselves tonight, are we really true believers? Allah says he will test you in your wealth. Your motor vehicle you have one day will be damaged. That is a test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As beautiful as it is, as expensive as it is, one day someone will scratch it just to see, is your heart connected to your vehicle or do you understand the plan of the Creator? And do you overlook and do you realize that really your anger and your temper are being tested here and now? Allahu Akbar. And your connection.